We're going to cover how to make a line graph. And so line graphs are really for times that you have a dichotomous IV, or not dichotomous, a nominal IV, but it's sort of treated as continuous. So for example, if you have test 1, test 2, test 3, those are sort of continuous where people have been in multiple tests because they're tested throughout the year, but they're not continuous in the sense of like they're not ratio or interval. The other option might be like if you were to do a drug study and you did dosage, so you gave some people 0, some people 10 milligrams, some people 20 milligrams, that is mildly continuous, as in the sense that that is going up, but I didn't test 5.5, so it's not ratio. And so line graphs are really used for those instances where you have independent variables that are listed as nominal, so they have categories, but those categories are treated as mildly continuous. That is different from a scatter plot with a line on it. And so scatter plots have two continuous variables that you can add a line of best fit, and that's not a line graph. So I'm going to show you how to make a line graph. So I'm going to go to graphs, and then chart builder. I don't quite have the right type of data for this because I don't have anything that is sort of continuous, but I can still show you how to make one. And so I hit clear because I've been doing some other videos, and then click on line, and let's do this simple line. So let me make a line graph with just one variable. I'm going to include party affiliation. So the x-axis has to be categorical or nominal in here. I'll show you in a second what it looks like if you don't do it with a nominal variable. It looks crazy. And then let's pick how many times Republicans and Democrats use six-letter words, which is my 6LTR here. I'm going to put that into count. If you have a nominal variable here, it will let you do display error bars, which we want to do. So you want to add those and hit apply. And what that's going to do is it's going to give me, for each category, it's going to give me a confidence interval around the mean, because if I have confidence intervals selected, I could do standard error or standard deviation. Most people do confidence intervals. I could change, don't forget to hit apply. Right? I could change my X and Y axis labels so that they are journal ready, aka they are proper case and they mean something. So let's pick Y, because this mean six letter isn't super useful. So I'm going to do average six-letter words. I'm going to make the minimum 0 because I know the minimum is 0, but I don't remember the maximum, so I'm going to leave it alone. If you have a specific type of scale, like a 1 to 5, make this right here 1 to 5 so that the scale on the y-axis matches the data. So be sure to hit apply or it will forget that I did all of that and then hit OK. So the chart I got for this is not super helpful because they're fairly similar in their measurements, but this is what a line graph would look like. So you want it to have little error bars and then the connection between the two. So this will be more appropriate as a bar graph because I have non-continuous data on the bottom, but I just wanted to show you how to make one. Here's what would happen if I tried to do this with the wrong type of variable. So if you go to graphs and then chart builder, let's say I didn't use party affiliation. I picked a real continuous variable. So six-letter words compared to the number of articles they used. So I'm going to stick articles in X here. And it's going to have a moment. So I'm going to just leave everything else set up the same way I did before. And then hit OK. And you'll see that it freaked out. Right? It didn't like that option at all. So let me try turning off error bars. So graphs on a chart builder. And I think if you start from scratch, we had six letter in Y, articles in X. Sometimes it won't let you even click display error bars. Apparently it will, but let's leave that off. Hit OK. And then it gives you this crazy graph. So if your Y or your X variable is not actually set up as a nominal variable, it will pretend to treat it like one, and so at every decimal point along the way, it has calculated the average, which does not give me a useful graph at all. So this is incorrect, and what you want more is a graph that looks like this. what if I had two variables that were both sort of continuous? I could treat that, or I had half and half. So I would go to graphs and then chart builder. And that would be this multiple line graph. So let's do this multiple line option. Actually, let me hit reset to get rid of all the messy data I had and then now do multiple lines. I'm gonna stick party affiliation in X, which we had before. And then you have to stick something here in set color. Anytime it has set color, it needs to be nominal. So remember, you can right click on variables and change them their type here in case you forgot to set it correctly. So I'm gonna stick that in set color. Let's pick 6-letter words and put it into count. I'm gonna tell it to give me display error bars because if you forget to do it in this window, this is the only window we seem to be able to get it to come up on. So if you forget error bars, you're gonna have to rebuild the graph. Okay. And I could go through and change everything in X and Y, but I'm gonna be lazy right now and just hit okay. And so now I have what I would consider a double line graph, or clustered line graph, or grouped line graph, all the same idea. So I have Republicans and Democrats, so I'm talking about how they're going from lower Republicans to higher Democrats, and then I've separated it by House and Senate. So I have, like, I could tell I have a slightly different line for the House than I do the Senate. And I would want to clean up all these X and Y axes, so I could double click on the graph. Remember, to change anything, you click on it once to get the option, and then click on it again to be able to edit it. So add a space there. So click once, click again. Let's do average 6-letter words. And then if I wanted to change location, again, it's click once, click again. And something I like to do is to double click on the big gray area, and under fill over here, click transparent, and that'll make it white, which to me is just much cleaner than these weird automatic gray graphs that they do. Close that and it will re-import into the window that you can copy from. And so that is how you make a line graph and then a grouped line graph.